I'm April Billingsley with the Dark Red.
April, it's amazing to have you here at FrightFest. What does it mean for you to be part of this unique celebration of genre cinema?
It's amazing. The fans are the best. I am having such a wonderful time. The Dark Red is a story about a woman who you're not quite sure whether she's crazy or not, but she claims her baby was stolen by a dark cult for its supernatural powers that come from its ancient bloodline.
I mean, that's quite a setup. I'm curious what it was about this role and that concept that most hooked you, most inspired you as a storyteller.
This role is incredible. She goes on this crazy journey from being insecure and vulnerable to being stuck in a psych ward to then going full on Sarah Connor. Like, come on! It was a dream role. I was delighted to do it.
I think obviously themes like motherhood and mental institutions, they're quite common tropes in, I guess, horror. I'm curious what you think's unique about this one, what people see from this that maybe haven't from other films in that area of the genre.
Right. So I'm trying, without trying to give anything away, this film isn't like anything you've seen before. Dan is an incredible storyteller, and the movie keeps surprising you. You think maybe it's going in one direction, but it's not. And you get to sort of see things through Sybil's perspective, and the themes and how the movie and the storytelling and even the visuals are told change throughout the movie. And I think audiences will be surprised by the changes and the differences, and it's not what you expect. I feel like I am part of the process of changing the perception of women in horror from something that maybe wasn't quite as embracing of a strong woman to something that now is, and I'm delighted by that.
Of course, we're here at Fright Fest celebrating the magic of horror. I'm curious if you can articulate for you what that is, what it gives both storytellers and audience they perhaps don't get from other types of cinema, other types of story.
I am very drawn, I love horror because of how it affects the viewer. When I watch it, I'll scream, or I don't do that in other movies, or you get grossed out or whatnot. It just affects people in a very deep way. I think it taps into something deep within us, sort of our, animal self or whatnot. Really goes deep into our psyche about what we're afraid of and what we love and what we're scared of and what we hate, and I think that's amazing about it.
Talking about amazing, can you talk to us just a little bit about working with an amazing team behind the camera on this, both your director and a wonderful stunt coordinator as well?
Yes, our team is incredible. I got to work with my friends and they were all amazing and these incredible creative people, and Dan was so collaborative and so many of the department heads were women. It was one of the best experiences of making a film that I've ever had.
My name is Daniel Bush. I'm the writer and director of The Dark Red.
It's amazing to have you with us at Fright Fest. What does it mean for you to be part of this year's festival?
It's huge. I mean, there's no word to describe how big this is for us, because we made this movie as a labor of love with limited resources, with our friends and family and the most talented people that we could gather around ourselves. And we're finally able to put it out into the world. And it's only because of the embrace of Fright Fest that we were able to do so, honestly. And we're just going where the love is, and the love is here. I wanted to do a movie that was from a specific perspective, an unreliable narrator. But in the movie, Sybil shows up in a hospital claiming that her baby was stolen by a secret society for its supernatural blood. And so she's trying to get her baby back. And, you know, the tagline that I came up with the other day is, the scariest thing about her story is that nobody believes it. So anyway, that was our impetus for the story. And we were like, let's follow this person. And as we were making the movie, Donald Trump got elected, there was the Women's March, and there were so many things that were happening in confluence around this that I just became very interested in a woman's perspective. And so I surrounded myself with our DP, Victoria Warren, and our production designer, and our costume designer, and our stunts, and April, and because I'm just a dude, but this is very much a female perspective, and so I really leaned on them heavily to help me understand and navigate those waters.
And in terms of finding the right person to give voice to that female perspective, can you talk about the qualities that April has that made her the right fit for this leading role?
Absolutely. Well, I needed somebody who was going to hang with us for the whole time and live through this, which is a hard job because you have to carry the character. And in this case, we shot it over a period of 2 years. And we had to take a break at one point for 6 months so that she could literally train and do a body transformation. And so I needed somebody who was as committed as April and as talented as April. And that was very hard to come by. And when I found her, I knew right away. And it's only due to her that we're able to have this movie at all. Horror is the human condition on steroids. It's a jet trip straight into the human condition and our greatest fears. And in a way, it's sort of like exposure therapy. And it's only through that experience that we can start to explore, you know, how we're going to behave, how we're going to react. What are the things deep inside of our psyche that are really troubling? And what I love about horror is when the monster, as we realize in the best horror movies, the monster is actually not outside. It's not external. The monster's inside. The monster's inside of our own thoughts and our own doubt and our own self-suffering. And the movies that draw that out in a way are my favorite horror movies. So.